Hello friends, welcome to Sri Medico. In this video we are going to see about the ECG interpretation. This video we are going to see about in individual use P wave, which indicates the atrial depolarization, PR interval, which indicates the AV node and bundle of his depolarization, and QRS morphology, which indicates the ventricular depolarization and QRS axis, and a special point called known as J point and ST segment, and T wave, which indicates ventricular repolarization. Before going to in video, please watch the previous video. They have discussed about the basics of ECG and its principle, so that you will understand this video better. Okay, we can go in detail. This is a small paper which indicates the whole of the ECG. You can take a screenshot of it, and you will after watching the full video, you can understand this paper in detail. First, we can discuss about the P wave. First, the P wave indicates atrial depolarization, and for the P wave we can look in lead 2. I have discussed in the previous video why we can check the P wave in lead 2, because there will be maximum positive deflection, so that the P wave can be seen very easily. So then the P wave is atrial depolarization, so we can find the atrial diseases. If there is any abnormality in the P wave, it indicates the atrial diseases, the right atrium and left atrium. The right atrial depolarization occurs vertically, and left atrial depolarization occurs horizontally. So we have, for a right atrial pathology, we can look for the height because it is vertical, and for the left atrial depolarization we can check for the width in the ECG paper. And there's a small criteria for every waves. So for P wave, we are looking for the lead 2. So normally, in normal ECG, the P wave in lead 2, the height will be less than 2.5 millimeter and width will be less than 2.5 millimeter. If this if the height is more than 2.5 millimeter, then it indicates right atrial pathology. And if the width is more than 2.5 millimeter, it indicates left atrial pathology. First, we can discuss about the P wave. When the P wave is absent, what it indicates? I have discussed in the previous video what is junctional rhythm. You can look in the ECG. In this, the P wave is present. In this, there is no P wave. You can see there is no P wave. So this indicates junctional rhythm. I have discussed what is junctional rhythm in the previous video. Watch it so you can understand in detail. Then it can be due to atrial fibrillation. I will discuss about the atrial fibrillation in the next video, in the arrhythmia, and it can be due to the electrolyte imbalance. It can be due to hyperkalemia. So when the P wave is absent, it indicates junctional rhythm, atrial fibrillation, and hyperkalemia. Next, this is a small table you can keep in mind. For right atrium, we have to look for the height in lead 2. And for the left atrium, we have to look for the width in lead 2. And for right atrium, in V1 there will be positive reflection. And left atrium, then V1 there will be negative deflection. This also I discussed in the previous video, why there is positive reflection, why there is negative deflection, what is positive and what is negative. So you watch the previous video so that you can understand it better. First, we can discuss about the right atrial enlargement. What are the causes of right atrial enlargement? It can be due to right ventricular failure. Right ventricular failure indicates cor pulmonale. I will discuss the cardiac disease in the upcoming videos. And right atrial enlargement can be due to tricuspid stenosis, tricuspid regurgitation, and right ventricular failure, COPD. I will discuss about the stenosis and regurgitation in the upcoming videos. So then, what is the criteria for the right atrial enlargement? For the right atrial enlargement, you have to look for the lead 2 height. Height should be more than 2.5 millimeter. And in lead 1, sorry, in lead V1, there will be positive deflection. You can see there, this is positive deflection. The positive deflection will be more than one small box. One small box is 0.5 millimeter in width. So in this ECG, you can see the P wave. The height is more than 2.5 millimeter. So it indicates right atrial enlargement. Right atrial enlargement is due to tricuspid stenosis, tricuspid regurgitation, and RVF, right ventricular failure. You can see there is a increase in height of P wave. Then we can discuss about the left atrial enlargement. The left atrial enlargement can be due to left ventricular failure or mitral stenosis or mitral regurgitation. The left ventricular failure can be due to systemic hypertension. What is the criteria for left atrial enlargement? I have discussed. For left atrial enlargement, we have to look for the width. In lead 2, we have to look for the width.
the width will be more than 2.5 millimeter. And in lead V1, there will be a negative deflection. The negative deflection will be more than one small box, that is more than 0.5 millimeter. See, you can see. And another one important thing you have to keep in mind is Morris index. What does Morris index means? It indicates the hypertension, whether patient is hypertension or not. The Morris index indicates it. You can see a negative deflection. This negative deflection, the negative deflection is more than one small box, that is more than 0.5 millimeter. In this ECG, you can see the P wave. You can see the P wave, it is heighter, it is more than 2.5 millimeter. So it indicates right atrial pathology, right atrial enlargement in this ECG. And in this ECG, you can see the P wave width is increased. See, you can see the P wave width is increased. So it indicates left atrial enlargement. So this is the simple P wave prediction in an interpretation. Next we can discuss about the PR interval. So what is PR interval? PR interval is due to AV node and bundle of his depolarization. I have discussed in the previous video, you can check it. So what is the normal PR interval duration? The normal PR interval duration is 0.14 to 0.20 seconds, and it indicates 3 millimeter to 5 millimeter in width. Next we can discuss the pathology. The PR interval can be increased or decreased. First you can discuss about the prolonged PR interval. What is prolonged PR interval? If the millimeter is more than 5 millimeter, it indicates prolonged PR interval. Why there is prolonged PR interval? If the AV node is blocked, what will happen? Automatically the PR interval will be increased. So what are the causes of AV block? It can be due to drugs, digoxin, beta blockers, or it can be electrolyte imbalance like hyperkalemia, hypokalemia, or it can be due to AV node infiltration. It can be due to amyloidosis or something, any systemic pathology, and it can be due to AV node degeneration. It can be age related, or it can be congenital, or anything. If it is age related, there will be calcification. If there is calcification, the disease is known as Leaves disease. If there is no calcification, it is known as Langerhans disease. See, in this ECG, you can see the PR interval is prolonged. This is P wave, this is R wave, the PR interval is prolonged. See, this is normal PR interval. Here the PR interval is prolonged, more than 5 millimeter. Next we can discuss about PR interval shortening. What is PR interval shortening? If the millimeter is less than 3 millimeter, it indicates PR interval shortening. I will discuss what is PR interval shortening. Normally, what will happen? The pacemaker SA node depolarizes the atrium. From the atrium, AV node, bundle office to ventricles, right ventricle and left ventricle simultaneously. So, how the pathology occurs? There is two pathway. It can be James pathway or bundle of Kent pathway. In James pathway, what happens is the right atrial impulse directly go to the bundle office. AV node is bypassed. So from the bundle office, the left ventricle and right ventricles are simultaneously depolarized. This is the pathway of James pathway, and this is known as LGL syndrome, Loewen-Ganong-Lewin syndrome. In bundle of Kent pathway, what will happen? The right atrial impulse directly go to the ventricles. It bypasses both AV node and bundle office. It can directly go to left ventricle, or it can go to right ventricle. So the right and left ventricle are not simultaneously depolarized. So it indicates what I have discussed in the previous video. If the ventricles are not simultaneously depolarized, the QRS complex will be wide. You check the previous video so that you can understand it. In James pathway, right atrial impulse to bundle of his and bundle of his to right and left ventricle. In bundle of Kent pathway, directly to the left ventricle or right ventricle, and it is not simultaneously depolarized. And this syndrome is known as WPW syndrome, Wolff Parkinson syndrome. You can see here the PR interval is very shortened. This is P wave, this is R wave. PR interval is very shortened. Sorry, P wave, R wave. PR interval is very shortened. P wave, R wave. PR interval is very shortened. This is the pathology, two important pathology. So this is the ECG. You can see where is the P wave. This is the P wave. This is R wave. This is R wave. This is P wave. The PR interval is increased. It indicates AV block. You can know the causes of the AV block. Here, this is P wave. This is R wave. The PR interval is very shortened. It can be due to LGL syndrome, James pathway, or bundle of Kent pathway, WPW syndrome. Next, we can discuss about the QRS. What is QRS? QRS means ventricular depolarization, and the criteria for QRS. Normal width of QRS is 0.08 to 0.11 second, and it can be 2 mm to 3 mm in width. If the QRS complex is wide, it indicates idioventricular rhythm. I have discussed the idioventricular rhythm in the previous video. You can check it and you will understand it. And it can be due to hyperkalemia or WPW syndrome. I will discuss what is WPW syndrome. The atrial impulse directly goes to the left ventricle or right ventricle. So the left and right ventricle not simultaneously depolarized, it is separately depolarized. So the ventricle depolarization will be increased. So the QRS also will be increased. You can see the QRS complex is increased. QRS complex is increased. QRS complex is increased. So it indicates idioventricular rhythm. Then we can talk about the morphology of QRS. This is the ECG. This is P wave. This is Q wave. This is R. This is S. This is T. This is normal ECG. And regarding QRS, how to find which is Q, which is R, which is S. Okay. First, the first positive deflection. This is the positive deflection. The first positive deflection is R wave. It should be more than 5 millimeter. And the wave just in the negative deflection before the R wave. The negative deflection before the R wave is Q wave. And the negative deflection after the R wave is S wave. If there is a second positive deflection, it indicates R dash wave, R dash wave. And if the positive wave is less than 5 millimeter, it indicates small R wave. Okay, this is the morphology and how you can find the Q, which is R, which is S. And then we can discuss some of the example for morphology of QRS. You can see there are many waves. The first positive deflection is R wave. This is the first positive deflection. But it is very small, less than 5 millimeter. So it indicates small R. The wave next to the positive deflection is S wave. So it is R, S wave. And here you can see the positive deflection. This is the positive deflection. It is more than 5 millimeter, capital R. The wave just before the positive deflection is Q. After the positive deflection is S. So it is Q, R, S. Here the positive deflection is R. There is no negative deflection before and after. So it is just R wave. You can see a negative deflection here. So the first negative deflection is Q wave. You can see the first positive deflection is here. But it is less than 5 millimeter. So it is small r. The negative deflection after the positive is S. And there is also another positive deflection. So we can indicate less than 5 millimeter. So it is R dash. It is R, S, R dash. Here the first positive deflection is here. Less than 5 millimeter R wave. Here the negative deflection. Yes. After the positive deflection is yes. And another positive deflection which is more than 5 millimeter. So we can indicate it in capital R. This R, S, R wave. This is the morphology of QRS. So what is QRS? It indicates ventricular pathology. So we can discuss about the right ventricular hypertrophy. The right ventricular hypertrophy can be due to pulmonary stenosis or due to pulmonary hypertension. So what is the criteria for right ventricular hypertrophy? What is the criteria for a right ventricular hypertrophy? In the V1, we have to look for the V1. In V1, the R wave, you can see the R wave. R wave should be more than 7 millimeter. In V1, if the R wave is more than 7 millimeter, it indicates right ventricular hypertrophy. You can see in this ECG, the R wave is more than 7 millimeter. More than 7 millimeter. So it indicates right ventricular hypertrophy. Next, we can discuss about the left ventricular hypertrophy. The left ventricular hypertrophy is due to aortic stenosis or it can be to systemic hypertension. What is the criteria for left ventricular hypertrophy? There are two criteria. The first criteria is in V1 and V2, the S wave should be deepest more than 35 millimeter. Plus the R wave in V6 and V5, it should be more than 35 millimeter. Or the RBF in AVL, left limb, it should be more than 12 millimeter. So for left ventricular hypertrophy, there are two criteria. The S wave in V1 and V2 should be more than 35 millimeter, plus the R wave in V5 and V6 should be more than 35 millimeter. Or it can be another criteria. The R wave in AVL should be more than 12 millimeter. In this ECG, you can see in V5 and V6, the R wave is more than 35 millimeter. More than 35 millimeter. And the S wave. And the S wave in V1 and V2 is more than 35 millimeter. So it indicates left ventricular pathology. In R wave, in V5, V6, more than 35 millimeter, and in V1, V2, S wave is more than 35 millimeter. Positive deflection, negative deflection indicates S wave. Then we can discuss about the right bundle branch block and left bundle branch block. It is simple. You can just keep in mind. For right bundle branch block, you can see rabbit ear pattern. This is like a rabbit ear, no, R, S, R dash pattern. For a left ventricular bundle branch block, there is R, R dash pattern, M pattern. For left ventricular, for right ventricular bundle branch block, we have to look for in lead V1. For left bundle branch, we have to look for in lead V6. For RBB, it is R, S, R dash pattern. For LBB, R, R dash pattern. In this ECG, you can see V1, R, S, R dash. You can see R, S, R dash pattern. So it indicates right bundle branch block. For LBB in V6, you can see R, R dash pattern. R, R dash pattern. Sorry, this one. R, R dash pattern. R, R dash pattern. So it indicates left bundle branch block. Next we can discuss about the QRS axis. I have discussed in the previous video what is lead 1, lead 2, lead 3, AVF, AVL, AVR and the axis. For this is lead 1. Lead 1 is 0 degree. Which limb lead is just perpendicular to the lead 1. That is AVF. I have discussed in the previous video. Watch it. AVF. Okay. And considered a heart is here. Consider it as a heart. So the lead one is just horizontal and AVF is just vertical to it. Just vertical to it. And this is right ventricle. This is left ventricle. Okay, this is just keep it in mind. The AV is just vertical and lead one is horizontal. The normal axis will be minus 30 degree to plus 110 degree. Okay, then we can discuss what is right axis deviation, what is left axis deviation. In case of right axis deviation, what will happen? In the right axis deviation, considered there is a right ventricular hypertrophy. There is a right ventricular hypertrophy. So what will be the net deflection? The net deflection will be towards the right ventricle. So this is lead 1, this is AVF, this is AVF. So towards AVF there is a positive deflection. You can see towards this is AVF and this is the deflection of the right ventricular hypertrophy. So in AVF there will be positive deflection. Automatically in towards lead 1 there will be negative deflection. So it indicates right axis deviation, right ventricular hypertrophy. In left axis deviation, in case of left ventricular hypertrophy, what will happen? The axis of deviation will be towards this side. Towards this side. So there will be this is lead 1, this is AVF. So there will be a positive deflection towards lead 1 and negative deflection towards AVF. This is the right axis and left axis. In right axis, there will be a positive deflection towards AVF, and in left axis, there will be a positive deflection towards lead 1. This is right ventricular hypertrophy. This is left ventricular hypertrophy. This is the QRS morphology and axis. Next, we can discuss about a special point known as J point. What is J point? You can see in the ECG. It is Q, R, S and T. The junction of QRS and T wave. The junction of QRS and the T wave is the J point. Junction of QRS and T wave is the J point. There are two ways we have to discuss in the J point. Here Osborne wave and epsilon wave. This is epsilon. First we can discuss about the Osborne J wave. In the CCG, this is Q wave, this is R, this is S, this is T. You can see a small wave here. This is a Q, R, S, T. You can see a small wave here. This is Osborne J wave. This important ECG will be asked in many MCQs. What are the causes of Osborne J wave? It can be due to hypothermia or hypercalcemia, or it can be due to brain injury or angina or ventricular fibrillation. Main important thing you have to keep in mind is hypothermia, hypercalcemia, and it can be due to also hypothyroidism. Can be due to hypothyroidism. Osborne J wave is due to hypothermia, hypercalcemia and hypothyroidism. Then we can discuss about the epsilon wave. Actually, for the Osborne J wave, we have to look in lead V2 to V5. We can see V2 to V5. We can find the pathology of Osborne J wave. For epsilon wave, we can check in lead V1. This is just I'll draw epsilon wave. This is epsilon. You can see the pathology here. Small deflection will be here. Small deflection. The epsilon wave is due to the right ventricular dysplasia, which indicates Naxos syndrome. I will be discussing in the next video. Next, we can discuss about the ST segment. There are different types of ST segment elevation. First, this is Q, this is R, this is S, this is T. You can see the elevation. This is a gravestone elevation. The convex is upward and the R wave is higher. The convex is upward and the R wave is higher. It indicates myocardial infarction. Then this is Q, this is R, this is S, this is T. You can see a smiling face. You can see a smiling face like this. It indicates acute pericarditis. In this, you can see this is Q, R, S, T. You can see a cowed appearance. Which indicates Brugada syndrome. Brugada syndrome is due to mutation in the sodium channel. I will be discussing in renal pathology. Next, you can see this is Q, this is R, this is S, this is T. You can see a tick, like a tick. Reverse tick or like a hockey stick. You can see like a hockey stick or a reverse tick, which is due to digitalis side effect. So these are the ST segment interpretation. This is like a gravestone, which indicates MI, the RU is tall, and this like smiling face, which indicates acute pericarditis. This is curved shape, which indicates Brugada syndrome, and this like a reverse stick or hockey stick, which indicates digitalis effect. See, in this CCG, you can see RU is taller, and there is a grave, which indicates MI. See, you can see RU is taller, and you can see a gravestone, which indicates MI. Here you can see a smiling face. This is Q, this is R, this is S, this is T. You can see a smiling face. Here also you can see a smiling face, which indicates acute pericarditis. In this, you can see there is a cowed appearance. can see a code appearance, which indicates Burgada syndrome. Here also see a code appearance. And here you can see a hockey stick or a reverse stick sign. You can see a hockey stick or reverse stick sign. Reverse stick. It's like reverse stick. Reverse stick sign, which indicates digitalis effect. So these are the ST segment interpretation. Next, we can discuss about T wave. You can see this is Q, this is R, this is S, this is T. The T wave is tall. The tall T wave indicates hyperkalemia. Potassium is increased. Hyperkalemia. Here you can see the T wave is tall, but it is somewhat round. It is sharp, which indicates MI. In MI, there will be early change in the T wave, which the T wave will be round in the top and tall. Then this is also a tall T wave, but there is an ST depression. ST depression with a tall T wave, which indicates D Winters T wave. D Winters T wave. What? Why the D Winters T wave is due to LAD stenosis. I have discussed what is LAD in the anatomy video. Please watch it with anterior wall MI. With anterior wall MI, a tall T wave with ST depression. Here also you can see a ST depression, but inverted T wave. Inverted T wave, which indicates Wellens T wave. Wellens T wave, which also indicates LAD stenosis. LAD stenosis with angina. And here you can see a T wave which is more than 10 millimeter, which is more than 10 millimeter, which indicates HOCM, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. So these are the T wave. The T wave is tall, which indicates hyperkalemia. The T wave is tall and round, which indicates MI. There is ST depression and tall T wave, which indicates D Winters syndrome. LAD stenosis with MI, and there is ST depression with the inverted T wave, which indicates Wellens T wave, which indicates LAD stenosis with angina. And the T wave is more than 10 millimeter, which indicates hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. This you can see a tall T wave, which indicates hyperkalemia. Here you can see ST depression with T wave, which indicates D Winters syndrome, LAD stenosis, which with anterior wall MI. And here you can see inverted T wave with ST depression, which indicates Wellens T wave, LAD stenosis, which causing angina. Here you can see the T wave is more than 10 millimeter, which indicates HOCM. There is a tall T wave, which indicates hyperkalemia, and there is a ST depression with the tall T wave, which indicates D Winters T wave, LAD stenosis with anterior wall MI. And you can see inverted T wave with ST depression, which indicates Wellens T wave, LAD stenosis with angina. And you can see T wave is more than 10 millimeter in more than 10 millimeter, so which indicates HOCM. That's all. This is the simple interpretation of the ECG. So watch the previous video, out of the basic principles of ECG, so that you can understand it better. And thank you for watching the video and subscribe our channel. And in the next video, you can discuss about the cardiac pathology and arrhythmia. Thank you so much.